Hey guys, what's up? Happy Sunday. Today is sort of life admin day. I'm not usually in the office, but I forgot my charger, so had to come in and wanted to film this for you guys as well. But today we're going to be talking about money. Roll the intro.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man. Yeah, but I was counting out like last week.
Alright, money's a really super sensitive topic, especially if you haven't grown up around it. My mum used to say, like, never ask anyone about money or talk about money. And my parents couldn't teach me about something that they didn't have. But here's a couple habits that I've picked up over the years, obviously off the back of reading books, having mentors, and just trying to get better and better. Money's become a big part of my life. I'm not motivated by money, I'm motivated by the things it can attain. And for me, that's financial freedom. Everyone's got a core set of values, from things that they value the most to things that they value the least. So for me, mine are business. Right now I'm doing a 75 health challenge, so I love doing that. The next part underneath that is financial freedom. So things that you value the most, you will spend time on, you'll spend money on, you'll think about. Things that you'll value the least, it's a bit of a chore. Probably 2 years ago, I wasn't that big into health. It felt like an effort to go out and exercise because that wasn't the highest part of my values. It's a lot of the times, that's a lot of people with savings as well. Rule number one for me is about money is I never talk bad about money. I got Caleb, who works for us now, 18 years old. Sometimes I hear him and he goes, oh fuck, I can't afford that. Pull him up straight away. You should never talk bad about money. Money is like people. If you talk bad about people, they won't come and hang around with you. And if you haven't heard this stuff before, I remember hearing it and I'm going, nah, that can't be true, that can't be true. But over time, like, my relationship with money has got a lot better. I always say, I have a great relationship with money, we grow and flow together. I have a great relationship with money, we grow and flow together. And since I've changed my habits in and around money, I get a lot more of it. So if you look at my wallet, I always have cash in here as well. I don't always use this cash, I use my card to pay for everything as well, but there's money that's always sitting in my wallet. It shows out to the universe that more of it's going to be coming in. I talked to Caleb, I go, what's your thoughts about money? And he goes, my uncle told me that you need to be saving for a rainy day. And what money is actually just an energy source. If you save money for a rainy day, what do you think the universe is going to give you? A rainy day. The universe is going to look at your rainy day account and it's going to name rainy day account and it's going to give you that. If you have a value on financial freedom and you put that towards there, you're going to acquire financial freedom. Next part is try and build multiple streams of revenue. I run YKTR right now. It's a business that basically built up mostly on my own, obviously got a team in that now. But it's my dream job. I love it. I love everything about it. But I'm still trying to acquire multiple streams of revenue. And I remember when I was a little bit younger, my dad lost his job. Got made redundant. Didn't lose his job. Got made redundant. And I remember how much pressure it put onto a family. And you can feel when people have got money pressures. They get sort of anxiety in and around them. And you know what it reminds me of? You know when you're driving and your petrol goes on down to E, and you're sitting there and you're like, fuck, I need to find a petrol station. You start to panic and you feel like you get all these red lights. A lot of the people are the same with money. They don't have a basic savings in there. They're not investing in that. Right now, bad things are happening in this world. I'm in a comfortable place right now because I've been saving, I've been investing. I'm not really panicking right now because I have multiple streams of revenue. And I want all you guys to have that. I'm not special. Like I've said before, like 3 years ago, I was going to the supermarket with coins in my hand. There's nothing special about me, but I do understand these things. So one, never talk bad about money. Two, try and build multiple streams of revenue. So I get paid from YKTR as a wage. I have a podcast that people sponsor. Hey guys, this podcast is brought to you by Cali Partners. They pay to be on that as well. I've got YKTR Sports. I don't make any money from that. That pays Scope and all those boys as well. But it has potential to grow. I do consulting as well. People pay me for my time. And then I also do online courses. The Inner Circle's been flying. Blueprint's been cool, man. A couple of people have got like six-figure businesses now off the back of that education. And that's how I had multiple streams of revenue. So when bad things start to happen and one takes a hit, I've got those other ones coming in as well. So really, really important, try and build multiple streams of revenue. I want you guys to start thinking about this stuff as well. Next one, I put a dollar value on my time. So what that means is, say, in my mind, my time is worth $1,000 an hour. If it doesn't equate to that, I won't go do it. I'll just go pay someone else to do it. And this sounds so bratty, but it's a habit of a rich person. This is what rich people do. So I want to try and do those as well. And I told my mum this. I told my mum, like, yeah. I told my mum this, I don't do my washing. I get someone to clean my house, because if I pay someone to do a washing, it costs me about $60 a week. And my value on my time is $1,000. So instead of me worrying about doing the washing and hanging it and drying it and folding it, which will take 2-3 hours over the course of my day, I can use that 2-3 hours somewhere else. I can use an hour reading a book where I can get a little bit smarter. I can be doing an hour doing an online course. I can be taking on consulting sessions. I get paid to podcast, so I could be doing 2-3 podcasts in that time where you could be getting more money in as well. So I hope that does make sense. And like I said, my mum was like, I didn't raise you like this. You're taught to do your own washing and cook your own food and clean your own shit up. And like, I do still do most of it as well, but if I can pay for someone to clean my house, my car, and have a wardrobe full of clothes that I'm ready to wear straight away, it's nice and clear. You know, when you've got a clean house, clean car, clean office, you sort of come to the work and you just feel a lot better. And that's what I sort of pay for. I pay for that time back so I can use it more effectively somewhere else. Next one, learn how to manage money. Like, today's a Sunday, I'll have my laptop here. I automate a lot of my savings. They go into investments like shares and stuff like this. They don't really have to ask me what I believe in. It's kind of like the S&P 500, look that up. But just do some research, man. Just study it. Start reading books. The great book from Tony Robbins, Money, Mastering the Game. Think and Grow Rich. Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Actually understanding what an asset is. But once you learn how to manage money, the world just gives you more money to manage. The universe gave me money and I start carrying on and start doing stupid stuff. A lot of the times, bad things start to happen. And I'll give you an example. One time I won $20,000 on a pokie machine. And I've talked about this a lot with YKTR. And got the money, carrying on. And I was getting, like, I believe in the pendulum swings. You always want to be neutral. Here's positive, here's negative. If you carry on too much, the universe is going to pull you back. And whenever I had like windfalls, doesn't happen to me anymore, because I understand this is, I always pull myself back to neutral. Because when I got that, I ended up getting like 3 or 4 fines. Ended up getting like 6K worth of fines. And every time the money comes in and I wasn't grateful for it, the universe would tick me up and give me a fine and stuff like that as well. So just learning how to manage money, learning where to put it, understanding that I have a value on money right now. I would just want to study it, learn about it, be grateful for it, appreciate it. And I found over the course, probably over the last year and a half and 2 years, a lot more of it's been coming in. I never speak bad about money. I'm trying to build multiple streams of revenue. Money is also a unit of service. So the better service you can provide, the more units that you are going to get. The more rare your service is and the more scalable your service is, the more units of money you are going to get. I've done a minimum wage job right now, so I was filling petrol up as an example. That skill set's quite easy to learn. Therefore, the units that you're going to get paid of money are going to be very high. You don't want to be trading time for money. So here's a couple of thought patterns. In and around money, never speak bad about it. Try and build multiple streams of revenue the best that you can. Own a bit of your own business. I feel like equity is really important. Even though all the boys that work for me, I always go to them, Scope, I need you to start your own business. Jackson's got his own business. Simi, how can we get something that you own equity in? Because you get more benefits of it as well. If you start trading your time for money, there's only so much time in a day as well. And then learn to manage money, learn to spend time with money, be grateful for money. I always have cash in my wallet. And on Sundays, for about half an hour, sort of sit down and go through my finances. It's like stepping on the scales. A lot of people are scared to step on the scales because the numbers are revealing. And if you look at how much debt you're in or how much money you're actually saving, sometimes it's an uncomfortable thing. But once you get to a certain point and you learn to confront that, things start to get pretty interesting as well. So if you want to learn more money lessons, jump in the inner circle. If not, we're back to work tomorrow. YKTR stuff, YKTR sports. I think I'm on about 6 or 7 podcasts this week, so I'll bring you guys for the journey. Later.
She see money all around me. I look like I'm the man.